In this video, I will talk about how to use the Big M method, which is a special case of the Simplex method, to solve linear programming problems with equality constraints, or greater than or equal to constraints. In the Simplex method, we need to find an initial basic feasible solution to start with. In the previous videos, we have found the initial basic feasible solution by using the slack variables as basic variables because we only had less than or equal to constraints. This does not work if a linear programming problem has equal or greater than or equal to constraints. In such a case, the Big M method may be used to solve the problem. Let's check this example. It's a maximization problem with two variables. We can use a graphic method to solve it, and the optimal point is E09. The star is equal to 18. We have a greater than or equal to constraint. We will use a Big M method to verify this optimal solution. The first step of the Big M method is to make sure the right-hand side of the constraints are non-negative. If the right-hand side of a constraint is negative, we need to multiply both sides by negative 1 to change it to a positive. For this example, the right-hand side are both non-negative, so we are good. Step 2. Convert the linear programming problem into the standard canonical form by introducing a slack variable S1 and an excess variable E2. Step 3. For each equal or greater than or equal to constraint, add an artificial variable. Add some restriction AI is greater than or equal to 0. This example only has one greater than or equal to constraint. So we introduce an artificial variable A2 in the second constraint and add it to the sign restriction. In step 4, we let m denote a very large positive number. For each artificial variable, add m times a to row 0 for the maximization problem. This modification makes it extremely costly for an artificial variable to be positive. After that, we rewrite the problem in the Simplex tableau. Step 5, eliminate all artificial variables from row 0 using EROs. Solve the transformed problem by the Simplex method. If all artificial variables in the final solution equal 0, the solution is indeed an optimal solution. If any artificial variables are positive, we have a fake optimal solution and the problem is infeasible. This is the original tableau. The artificial variable has a coefficient m in row 0. Now let's subtract row 0 by m times row 2. This will be gone. Other coefficients and the right-hand side are also updated. In this tableau, S1 and A2 are basic variables, and others are non-basic variables. Let's set non-basic variables to 0 and solve for basic variables. S1 is equal to 9, A2 is equal to 9, and Z is equal to negative 9m. The entering variable will be X2 because it has the most negative coefficient in row 0. The ratio is the right-hand side divided by the coefficient of X2. 9 over 1 and 9 over 2. Row 2 has the smallest ratio, so it is a pivot row. We need to change this to 1 and make it disappear from other rows using EROs. This is the updated tableau. X2 and S1 are basic variables, and others are non-basic variables. Let's set non-basic variables to 0 and solve for basic variables. S1 is equal to 9 over 2, X2 is equal to 9 over 2, and Z is equal to 9. The entering variable will be X1 because it has the most negative coefficient in row 0. The ratios are 3 and 9. Row 1 has the smallest ratio, so it is a pivot row. We need to change this to 1 and make it disappear from other rows using EROs. This is the updated tableau. X1 and X2 are basic variables, and others are non-basic variables. Let's set non-basic variables to 0 and solve for basic variables. X1 is equal to 3, X2 is equal to 3, and Z is equal to 15. The entering variable will be E2 because it has the most negative coefficient in row 0. The ratio for row 1 is 9, for row 2 is none, because this coefficient is a negative value. So row 1 is a pivot row. We need to change this to 1 and make it disappear from other rows using EROs. This is the updated tableau. X2 and E2 are basic variables, and others are non-basic variables. Let's set non-basic variables to 0 and so for basic variables. E2 is equal to 9, X2 is equal to 9, and Z is equal to 18. Now the coefficients of all non-basic variables are positive, so this tableau is optimal. The optimal solution is X1 is equal to 0, X2 is equal to 9, S1 is equal to 0, E2 is equal to 9, A2 is equal to 0. Z star is equal to 18. Because the artificial variable A2 is equal to 0, so this is a true optimal solution. Also, this solution is the same as the one we got using the graphic method. Now let's check the second example. The only difference is that this is changed from 9 to 4. We can try the graphic method first, and we find the feasible regions of these two constraints have no intersection, so the problem is infeasible. Let's use the Big M method to verify this. For this example, the right-hand side are both non-negative, so we are good. This is the only difference in step 2 and step 3. This is the only difference in the initial simplex canonical form. Now there are more changes in step 4 and along the simplex iterations. The right-hand side, the basic variable, and the ratio are all different. As a result, the pivot row is changed to row 1 because the ratio is smaller. Let's continue, and the changes are marked in red. Now the coefficients of all non-basic variables are positive, so it seems this tableau is optimal. The optimal solution is x1 is equal to 0, x2 is equal to 4, s1 is equal to 0, e2 is equal to 0, a2 is equal to 1, Z star is equal to 8 minus m. Because the artificial variable A2 is equal to 1, which is greater than 0, so this is a fake optimal solution. We can also see that in the Z star value, m is a large positive number, so Z star can be infinitely small. Therefore, we conclude this problem is infeasible. Okay, that is how to use the Big M method to solve linear programming problems with equality constraints or greater than or equal to constraints. Thanks for watching.